It's not easy being the loony lockdown lunatic leader in the post-COVID era. That's right. Jacinda Ardern has resigned as Prime Minister of New Zealand. Now, it's unfortunate that the World Economic Forum's young global leader, Jacinda Ardern, won't be at the helm of New Zealand anymore. But, you know, we should take a quick look and remember all the great things she did during COVID. It should be noted that when even CNN is finding you a bit extreme, it is worth examining your behavior. On August 17, 2021, New Zealand announced it was locking down the entire country of New Zealand over one COVID case. Jacinda Ardern truly took the cake when it came to lunatic policies over COVID. But we shouldn't be surprised at the lunacy of Jacinda Ardern. This is a woman that on the record compared free speech to a weapon.
How do you ensure the human rights of others are upheld when they are subjected to hateful and dangerous rhetoric and ideology? The weapons may be different, but the goals of those who perpetuate them is often the same: to cause chaos and reduce the ability of others to defend themselves.
Do you mean like the way that you prevented New Zealanders from defending themselves from your lunatic lockdowns and forced everyone to fall in line or face the blunt force of your government? In a post announcing the resignation, Jacinda Ardern had the following to say. She said, "I am now entering my sixth year of office, and for each of those years, I have given my absolute all." Well, you sure did the last 2 years, didn't you? She said, "I believe that leading a country is the most privileged job anyone could ever have, but also one of the more challenging. You cannot and should not do it unless you have a full tank plus a bit in the reserve for those unexpected challenges." She said, "This summer, I had hoped to find a way to prepare for not just another year, but another term, because that is what this year requires. I have not been able to do that. And so today, I am announcing that I will not be seeking re-election and that my term as Prime Minister will conclude no later than the 7th of February." The New Zealand Prime Minister then went into a bit of a sob story about woe is me and it's time to step away. Let's watch.
"This has been the most fulfilling 5.5 years of my life. I am leaving because with such a privileged role comes responsibility. The responsibility to know when you are the right person to lead and also when you are not. I know what this job takes, and I know that I no longer have enough in the tank to do it justice. It's that simple. I know there will be much discussion in the aftermath of this decision as to what the so-called real reason was. I can tell you that what I'm sharing today is it. The only interesting angle that you will find is that after going on 6 years of some big challenges, I am human. Politicians are human. We give all that we can for as long as we can, and then it's time. And for me, it's time. Today I'm announcing I will not be seeking re-election, and that my term as Prime Minister will conclude no later than the 7th of February."
And so on behalf of all freedom-loving people all across the globe, I want to say the following to Jacinda Ardern upon her resignation. Don't let the door hit your rear end on the way out. And I hope that the young global leaders, the World Economic Forum's association, has a spot for you either with them or can find you a spot with the World Economic Forum. I'm Greg Staley for Diverge Media. Until next time.